So I is intelligence. We need intelligence to know what is love and what is not love. Why? Because we see Kaikeyi acted out of, she thought she was acting out of great love. Somehow she was misled into believing that Ram's coronation would mean Bharat's deprivation, even Bharat's destruction. That's what Mantara misled her into believing. And she thought, Bharat is my son. I have to protect him. I have to protect his interests. And she believed everything that she is doing was for Bharat. And everybody reviled for the horrendous demand that Ram be exiled. And especially when Sita, the tender princess, put on tree bark, everybody's heart in Ayodhya broke. But Kaikeyi's heart had become so hard that nothing penetrated into it. So she thought she was doing all this because nobody was understanding her part of the her side of the story. Thought that I'm doing all this for Bharat. Bharat is the prince. He should become the king. And why are they not understanding? I'm doing all this for Bharat. So she actually did it out of, she thought she was doing it out of love. So now, we often do wrong things, but we rarely do wrong things so confidently and aggressively as when we are convinced that we are doing it for a right cause. Normally, if somebody kills, they might have some hesitation. They might have, oh, killing is wrong. How can I take somebody's life like this? But if somebody is misled by an ideology, it might be, say, ideology of religious extremism, where people start believing that this person is blaspheming our sacred conceptions. And then killing him is a sacred duty. So people kill righteously and they celebrate. I did something glorious. And this is not just religious ideology. There is can be atheistic ideology also. In during communism, 100 million people were killed. More than any other ideology is killed throughout human history. They're killed righteously for the sake of prosperity, for the sake of the poor. That was the reason given. So we never do wrong as aggressively as when we think we are doing it for a right cause. So even when we are loving something, we need our intelligence to evaluate, is what I'm doing right? Is my love rightly directed? So Kaikeyi thought it was love. So I said that to illuminate our heart, we need love. But what do we mean by love? What is actual love? For different people, love can mean different things. At an extreme level, as I said, terrorists think they're loving God or loving their religion, but they're killing people. So similarly, Kaikeyi thought she was loving Bharat, but she was causing havoc in her kingdom. She caused the death of her husband. It was when Bharat came and Bharat's intelligence was sound. And Bharat told Kaikeyi, what have you done? He was aghast that Kaikeyi, that his own mother could do something. And he was even more aghast that his mother was thinking that she was doing all this for his sake. And he was most appalled to think that she was thinking he would be pleased by all this. He said, you can't be my mother. You must be the goddess of destruction incarnated in our family to destroy our whole dynasty. And when he jolted her, when he spoke such jolting words, that was the time when Kaikeyi's intelligence awakened. And she realized what a horrible thing she had done. She had an imaginary Bharat in her mind. She thought that Bharat is appreciating all that I'm doing for him. But the real Bharat came and he was not only disapproved, but actually lambasted her. Then she came out of her stupor. So, what is love and how it is to be expressed that requires intelligence? Exposed to Kaikeyi how she was terribly misled and she had been terribly, her actions had been terribly misery causing. So that's what brings us to the next point of I. Intelligence shows what is love and what isn't. So quite often selfishness and various forms of exploitative ideas can also take the mask of love. And that's why we need scriptural understanding. We need to develop our intelligence to know what is love and what is not love. तस्मात् शास्त्रम प्रमाणम ते कार्या कार्य व्यवस्थित ज्ञात्वा शास्त्र विधानोक्तम कर्म कर्तुम इहारसि. कृष्णा सेज थ्रू शास्त्र लर्न व्हाट इज टू बी डन एंड व्हाट इज नॉट टू बी डन. कृष्णा टॉक्स अबाउट बुद्धि दैट वाज 1624. इन 1830 कृष्णा टॉक्स अबाउट बुद्धि इंटेलिजेंस इन गुडनेस एंड ही सेज that buddhi which understands pravrittim cha nivrittim cha karya karye bhaya bhaye bandham moksham cha yavetti buddhi saparth satviki. That is the buddhi in goodness which knows what is to be done, what is not to be done, what is to be feared and what is not to be feared, what will cause bondage, what will cause liberation. So in the name of love we might end up entangling and binding ourselves, so we need intelligence for that purpose. So here we see there's heartbreak. Dashrath is begging, please don't go. How can you go like this? Stay at least for one day. And Ram said that if I have to go, why should I stay? You know, one more day will simply mean one more day of agony. And then eventually the same thing has to be done. So let me leave right away. And Ram remained very sober and grave. And he ensured that things that were bad didn't become worse. He didn't act like a victim. He didn't protest how unjust life is to me. His love was shown at this stage by concealing his emotions. Nowadays, love is associated very much with effusive displays of devotion, displays of love. So public display of affection is quite common. In some culture, that might be the norm. But there are times when love is shown by expressing emotions. And there are times when love is shown by concealing emotions. So Ram was shocked. Ram was himself shattered by what had happened. Of course, he's the Lord and nothing happens to him. But in terms of the Leela, whatever emotions he was going through, he didn't show them. Because he didn't want to make bad things worse over there. So his love was shown by his being very calm. He was calming everyone else. Everybody was saying, this is so unjust. And you're saying, no, it's all right. Just 14 years will go, like 14 days and I'll be back soon. Please don't make a big deal out of this. So that is Ram's gracefulness. So Ram is now going out, and when he was going out, he was leaving, the light of Ayodhya was leaving. As he left, Ayodhya started becoming darker and darker, not physically darker, the sun was there, but the sun in their heart, who was the son of their king, was leaving. And as he was leaving, there was nothing that they could do. Ayodhya became like a ghost town. Hardly any activity. Even if people went around their activities, they were just so lackadaisical. They just didn't feel like living. So that is what unfortunately happens when our love is misdirected. When we start loving the things of this world more than the Lord of the world, then we unwittingly exile the Lord from our heart. And there are many mantra-like people who will incite us to love the things of this world. The whole advertising world, the whole materialistic culture is glamorizing. Get this, you'll be happy. Buy this, get this. And as our minds become filled with images of enjoying this and possessing that and doing that, then gradually all those impressions start filling our heart. And then there's no place for the Lord left over there. And then the Lord leaves. So that's how it is. If the Lord is present in our hearts, so the Lord can be exiled if we are not using our intelligence. And we need intelligence to invoke the Lord's presence back in our hearts.